Hublot is always a fun brand to watch. They don't pull punches and they march to the beat of their own drum. So I've got Danny and John here to walk through the 2021 new releases at Watches and Wonders from Hublot.
The biggest surprise from Hublot for me would undoubtedly have to be the Big Bang Integral Tourbillon Full Sapphire. Just honestly, seeing a watch completely made of sapphire to this degree, and while not technically all sapphire, the sheer concept is so inherently Hublot that we all should have seen it coming to some degree, and yet it's still surprising.
For me, the biggest surprise from Hublot was also the Big Bang Integral Tourbillon Full Sapphire. And I would just add the fact that they released it alongside like a totally, we'll say conventionally iced out watch of the same type. It's just really cool to like look at these watches against each other. You know, on the one hand, you have like the traditional way to ice out a watch, and then you have Hublot saying like, well, it can be done this way too, which is like very much us.
For me, it would have to be that it's still difficult to make ceramic cases in certain colors. We learn it every single year, and this year we've learned that it's yellow. So while we all talked about the sapphire, Hublot also went and released a yellow ceramic watch, which was the Big Bang Unico Yellow Magic. And if you hadn't told me that yellow was difficult to produce in ceramic, looking at this, I would never have known it, because this is about as yellow gets, and it's as loud as yellow gets, which is completely fitting for Hublot. So just learn that Hublot's not afraid to take on a challenge, and they generally deliver.
Yeah, I think what we learned about Hublot is that they're going to do Hublot, right? Like, they're going to make crazy concept watches that use new materials and kind of blow us away. And they're also going to make super brightly colored ceramic Big Bangs that, for a certain type of collector, are catnip. And they can do both of these things side by side and end up with a brand with its own distinct identity that, for a particular sort of consumer, is highly, highly covetable.
Between diamonds and sapphire, I would undoubtedly take the sapphire for no other reason than I would love to know what my wrist looks like through a case and bracelet of a watch.
I also think I'm going to have to go sapphire over diamonds, and anybody who's been following Hodinkee knows I love a good flooded watch, but to me this is the same thing but in a much more contemporary and unique way.
I think Hublot tends to nail it with their collaborations with artists because, well, for one, they're a brand that was founded in the 1980s, so they don't come with a ton of history. It's not a brand that I think has ever put on airs, really. And so they're able to meet the artist on equal footing. And I think that's important. I would imagine for an artist, it would be very different to go to a 200 or 250-year-old brand and say that they could speak for them or interpret their designs. When you're dealing with a brand that is, you know, 40 years old, it's a different story. My favorite Hublot this year is made of all sapphire, full stop.
My favorite Hublot is just the same, the Tourbillon Full Sapphire. It's so interesting to look at just in the images and something I can't wait to see in the metal.
Yeah, I think everybody's been listening to and watching the official or unofficial Hublot Big Bang Integral Tourbillon Full Sapphire fan cast here. We are all super into this watch, and I actually think this to me is one of the best watches of the week. And I really can't wait to see this one in person.